Good morning, one and all. Welcome back for the lecture series on composite materials. Now, in today's class, we are going to see what is a glass fiber and what are the various things to be considered while we have to learn about a glass fiber. But before going into the into today's class, let us briefly recap about the previous lecture. What we have actually discussed in previous lecture is fiber reinforced composite. What are the compositions of a fiber reinforced composite? The first being a fiber material taken as a reinforcement, and the second being a matrix material which is taken as a gluing substance. Okay, apart from those two, we have also seen that there will be sometimes some special type of materials which will be considered. They are called as filler materials or modifier materials, or sometimes also taken as additive materials. Okay, so I R Ranjit Kumar, Assistant Professor of Mechanical Engineering Department, Vignan Institute of Technology and Science, welcome you all for today's discussion. Now, let's start our discussion, right? What's the first thing we need to do? We need to study about glass fibers. What is a glass fiber? Who invented it? And when did this glass fiber come into existence? Glass fiber was actually first invented by a person named Rene Fairchild de Remer. And why did he invent this? It was actually an accidental invention, but after his invention, there is a complete change in the face of production history, right? Though there was not a large scale production which was carried till 18th century, after 18th century, the glass fiber utilization came into picture, and different organizations, different industries started using this glass fiber to prepare, to fabricate different types of fiber reinforced composites, right? It was actually not technically possible due to the type of mechanism which was available at that particular point of time, or the expertise of the persons or whatnot. The reasons might be n number, but it has not been technically possible to wave the thin glass fibers into fabrics. It was not actually possible. It was they never came across with a particular technique or a particular method by using which they can wave. Waving is like stitching, right? Waving one into the other to prepare a fabric and such type of things. Okay, next. After the 18th century until 1935, as we have already discussed, that Owens Corning, the one who started, who established a fiber composite company, he went into an understanding with a company, a glass company, which is called Illinois Glass Company. But their contribution was also not so brought into the limelight until the glass fiber was turned into a yarn. What is a yarn? A substance like this, like the thread, the spun off thread which we will be using for fabricating, for preparing fabrics and so on things, right? Okay. So until and unless the glass fiber was turned into a yarn, the usage of this glass fiber was not so good at that particular point of time. Then after that, the composite material, which is which was actually first used in aviation industry in 1942, then that understood that the aviation industry understood the importance of this glass fiber and then started using this glass fiber till then. From then, even it is used till today. Okay, since then, we have already discussed in this in the previous class about this high strength low density fiber, glass fiber, S2, and all those things we have already dealt, right? Since then, when S2 was evolved from S glass, that S2 glass fiber has been very, very, very rapidly used in many commercial applications. Let it be marine applications or in aerospace applications or automobiles or domestic applications, whatnot. Any commercial application had S2 type glass fiber in it. The development of this fiberglass or the glass fiber shooting methods and the technology has also been very, very, very effective because of those effective methods. This S2 fiberglass was rapidly used. Okay, and now After 1942, when this when the first composite material was actually used, very cheap plastic or poor plastic and insulation materials, they were actually brought into limelight because they were very rapidly used. But after 1950s and 60s, it has been the main component of modern life in many areas. What are those many areas? Like, as I have made a point here, surface cladding, roof cladding, facade cladding, to the textiles, from that particular points to textiles sectors, automotive industries, aircraft productions, and even armor makings. Whenever we want to prepare an armor, that armor should have less weight, but it should withstand lot of impact. It should not get pierced, right? So that armor making has also used, is also getting, is also being, is also making use this S2 type of fiber glass, or the glass fiber for its production. What is cladding? Cladding is nothing but the painting or the surface finishing, what we do for our walls which are under construction. That is called cladding, facade cladding, surface cladding, or roof cladding, and so on. Okay, next, the main glass fiber classes. How do we classify glass fibers and what are their uses? For example, generally, if you take, I don't have any necessity to classify a glass fiber, but if you talk about the necessary, if you want to classify a glass fiber, then the glass fibers can be classified into two categories: general purpose and special purpose, based on their purposes. The most well-known formula, which is nothing but our E-glass, electrical glass, or the glass which can conduct electricity, E-glass fiber is commercially referred to as glass fiber. So whenever you talk about, whenever you take out the word glass fiber, that basically generally represents an E-glass fiber. Okay, next, we have other types of fibers which are also called special types. And we are listing out here various types of glass fibers, which are as follows. The first being S glass fiber, the second D glass fiber, and third A glass fiber, fourth ECR glass fiber, and the fifth ultra pure silica fibers, sixth being hollow fiber, and which follows with trilobal fibers and special purpose glass fibers. Let me give you the list again, so that, as it is very important: S glass, D glass, A glass, ECR glass, ultra pure silica fibers, hollow fibers, trilobal fibers, special purpose glass fibers. And these, not among these things, they can have different combinations, different varieties among themselves. Let's see about those combinations or varieties which they have. These type of glass fibers, which are namely like A, C, D, E, Advantex, ECR, AR, R, S2, M, T, and Z, they are the fiber types which are most commonly used to form a composite material. Whenever we want to prepare a composite material, by default, we will be considering only these categories. What are those categories? A, C, D, E, Advantex, ECR, AR, R, S2, M, T, and Z. And the composite materials which are formed by using all these categories of glass fibers, they are generally named as fiberglass materials. They are called as fiberglass materials. Okay. Now, what are the raw materials which we'll be using for producing a glass fiber? The basic substance, the very basic ingredient, the basic substance that forms the glass fiber is actually known as glass. So we are using a glass as a basic ingredient. The difference between the glass in nature is the soda lime or the borax silicates. So we'll be differentiating that glass which is naturally available to us, or which is generally taken in nature, can be differentiated as the difference between these two will be the soda lime, or which is also called as borax silicates. Okay, the soda lime glass is produced. How can it be produced? It's produced by dissolving limestone calcium carbonate CaC2, limestone and soda and sand at temperatures ranging from 1400 degrees centigrades to 1500 degrees centigrades. Okay, so in this particular ranges, we will be mixing up those components so to have a soda lime glass prepared. Next, commercial glass fiber production is also obtained by mixing the following materials. We have a list of materials which I'll be showing in the next slides, right? We also have different properties that can be desired, that can be achieved by using these things, right? So it can be obtained by mixing the following materials, and we also can get the desired properties. And what are those materials? Aluminium, boron, calcium, magnesium, zinc, barium, lithium, mixed alkalis, zirconium, titanium, iron containing oxides or fluorine. I'll again go back to the previous slide because even this list is also important, so make a note of it. Aluminium, boron, calcium, magnesium, zinc, barium, lithium, mixed alkalis, zirconium, titanium, and iron containing oxides or fluorine. Okay, now finally, in today's topic, we will see what are the different compositions of each and every type of glass fiber. See, you can observe in this particular tabular column, we have A type glass fiber, C type glass fiber, D type glass fiber, E type glass fiber, Advantex, ECR glass fiber, AR type glass fiber, R type glass fiber, and S2 type glass fiber. And we have in the second row, we have percentage of oxides. So we are going to deal with the percentages of various oxides which we are using for producing them. You can observe carefully that the first being silicon dioxide, SiO2. And what about the ranges? The A type glass fiber is having 63% to 72% of silicon dioxide. You can see here, observe, you can observe that, right? That 63% to 72%. Next, we have the C type, which is 64% to 68% of silicon dioxide. And next, we have D type, which is 70% to 75%. And next, we have E type, which is 52% to 56%. And then Advantex ranging from 59% to 62%, ECR glass ranging from 54% to 62%, and the AR type from 55% to 75%, R type from 56% to 60%, and S2 type from 64% to 66%. This is the range of composition of this particular silicon dioxide which will be mixed, which will be considered in order to prepare a glass fiber. Next, the case with alumina, which is Al2O3 alumina oxide, silicon dioxide, the same way we have alumina, and next we have magnesium oxide, zinc oxide, barium oxide, lithium oxide, sodium oxide, which is also mixed with the potassium oxide, Na2O plus K2O, and we also have titanium dioxides, zirconium dioxides, iron oxides, right? So all these are nothing but various oxides which we are using, which we are mixing to prepare a glass fiber material or a fiberglass material, composite material, starting with silicon dioxide, alumina, which is also aluminium oxide, magnesium oxide, zinc oxide, barium oxide, lithium oxide, sodium oxide, and which is also taken in combination with potassium oxide. That means whatever the element we are using, we are mixing to get desirable properties, all those oxides are considered here. And what about the different types of glass materials we are considering? A, C, D, E, Advantex, ECR, AR, R, and S2. For all these various categories of glass materials we are using, we are considering what amount of composition. This is what this tabular column is explaining to us, right? So titanium dioxide, zirconium dioxide, and iron oxide. Okay, so in the next class, today I'm going to stop our lecture at this point, and in the next class we will see about each and every category of this subclassification of this glass fiber material, and we will see, if possible, how each and every type of glass fiber material is also manufactured by using, if possible, I'll make use of some pictorial representations and I'll clearly explain you, right? So with this, I'll take a leave for today, and thank you. We'll meet in the next class.